Three words on your screen. Change is needed. Welcome to Mavericks Today. It is Harrison Graham and Jeffrey Cooperstein. And Coop, obviously, a lot of trade rumors, a lot of chatter the last couple of weeks leading up to the deadline. Yep. And, you know, that's kind of going to be a part of this show. But this team right now, Coop, I think we got to take an episode today to just talk through some of these issues. They're just not playing good ball right now.
Yeah, we love all the trade rumors and we love about what the Mavs can do, but we had to take a moment and take a look at what they are doing right now. And last night was just not a good showing on all fronts by the Dallas Mavericks. It was really embarrassing. They played a first 15 to 18 minutes that were really good. And after that, they got smoked and Phoenix ran them out of the gym. So just a few takeaways that I had from last night as well. Number one, it starts with this. Luka needs to be mentally tougher, man. Yeah. There's a lot of talk about how he got that fan thrown out or tossed out of his seat from the game, and he was heckling Luka all game and whatnot. That's just part of it. I think Luka also needs to be mentally tougher when it comes to the officiating. He lets the officiating get to him, and that impacts his play, especially on the defensive end, where he, when he's engaged, is a good defender. But right now, he's just not there on that side of the ball, and I think that a combination of the refs, a combination of the heckling, and a combination of the team not playing well is just doing him no good.
Yeah, and look, we were talking about this off camera, and I said, I actually thought the first, 30 games or so, Luka had turned a corner a little bit. Now, he's always going to be a guy, like most superstars are, that bitch about calls here and there. But I thought this year he had done a better job of picking his spots on when to do that. Yep. But you're absolutely right when you responded and said, yeah, the last few weeks he's reverted back to old habits. And I think the biggest reason why is, well, what's been happening the last few weeks? They're losing basketball games. Like, they're not playing good right now. So he's got to step up and be the leader and just find a way to grind through the stretch. Every good team goes through a bad stretch. The question is this going to be a team that is actually a good team and gets back on track, or are they going to let this stretch derail their season? Luka's got to be the guy that stops the bleeding.
Yeah, and I think also it also has to do with Kyrie being out as well. I think Luka feels more pressure to deliver because he's the only guy on offense who can really score at a consistent level. And when teams know that, they're going to key on him like they did in starting in the middle of the second quarter. Phoenix put Josh Okogie on him, and he got up into Luka's shit, for lack of a better term, and Luka never really recovered from that throughout the game. So he's got to find a way to respond better to adversity, and that's kind of my main takeaway from last night is we need Luka to be better.
Are you guys concerned about Luka as a leader? Type Y for yes, type N for no. Not overly concerned. I'd say I'm mildly concerned. Again, you got to find a way to navigate these tough stretches, and last night it just seemed to reach kind of a boiling point for this team. So let us know what you guys think, Y for yes or N for no. We got to talk Jason Kidd, Coop. This was a big talking point on Mavs Twitter last night.
No doubt.
There were a lot of memes going around. Jason Kidd, after the opposing team goes on
Arthur the Aardvark 26 to 2
run, and he's just, there's just no emotion. And look, like, you can't be someone you're not, but you can't do nothing either,
exactly,
if that makes sense. Like, he's got to find a way to leave an imprint on a game when things aren't going well.
Yeah, and he hasn't got a technical all season long. And you know what? Most of the time you would say that's a good thing. But on a game like last night where your team has completely lost its marbles and just doesn't know what they're doing out there, it's good for a coach to go yell at a ref and go get a technical foul. Just show the team that you're still there, you still care about that game, and you still have the passion and the fire to go compete. Whether it's at a ref or at another player, at another coach, you want to see some sort of fire. I know Jason Kidd's a very mild-mannered guy, but at some point, you have to give the team a spark if they need it.
That's something I actually used to really like about Rick Carlisle, is either in games that had completely gotten away from him and he knew you weren't coming back, or just in spots to defend a player, he would kind of intentionally go get
absolutely
a technical foul. And I think it does a couple of things. I think, one, it in a game that's lost, it can give you a jolt of energy heading into the next game. Or two, it kind of just shows your players, like, hey, man, like, yeah, that was bullshit. You don't need to say anything, though. I will be the one who says it because I'm the head coach. And I agree. I think at times it's worth, the other team getting a possession or a free throw or whatever it is, because you just you got to just send that kind of proverbial
message.
You got to
show that you're there for your guys,
yeah,
basically. I mean, I know I'm a big Jason Kidd defender. I love a lot of the things he does with this team, but that is one of my main criticisms of him, is he doesn't show enough emotion, where it's sometimes a head coach just needs to, plain and simple.
Yeah, I completely agree. Make sure you subscribe to Mavericks Today. We are your one-stop shop for Mavericks coverage leading up to the NBA trade
deadline. 2 weeks from today.
2 weeks from today, and changes needed is the theme of the show. So obviously making a trade would certainly be a change, and we definitely agree that needs to happen. So hit that sub button. We'll cover everything between now and then. Number three, stop just settling for jump shots, especially when you're in this funk right now where you're not making that many.
They refuse to go to the hole when things get tough, and they're a jump shooting team, and I get that, but at some point you have to go to the rim. And like when Luka gets double teamed, he gets very impatient and frustrated, and he just starts jacking up threes, and that's not his game. His game is he's able to go to the hole, drive, and kick. He's also a decent three-point shooter, but you don't want him shooting at crazy volumes like he has been over the last week or so. And when the jump shots aren't falling, the offense looks really bad, like in that third quarter last night.
Yeah, and look, maybe this is part of the construction of the roster, and especially when Kyrie's been out, because Kyrie's a guy that – you can just give the ball to and get out of the way.
And he's
going to get into the paint, yep. Floater game going, and all that stuff. So I definitely think that plays a role. But I'm with you. Like, if you're, you know, I'd have to go look at numbers. I feel like this team's probably shooting at about 30% from three the last handful of games or so. Like, you've got to just try to find a way to get easier shots.
You got to do something different when it's not working. And whether that's going to the hole, whether it's taking more mid-range jumpers, whether it's, you know, completely changing up the offense. And that falls on Jason Kidd as well, where he has to make adjustments to get this team more easy looks and get them in a rhythm. So they simply just have to stop settling for jumpers, especially the ones that Tim Hardaway takes. I know he's been very hot lately, but when he takes those 19-foot contested jumpers, it just boils my blood.
Yeah, it's not good at all. What is good is Prize Picks and making money with Prize Picks. And listen, we got Championship Sunday in the NFL and tons of different opportunities to put your money down with. 2-6 player entries. Make some money all weekend long at prizepicks.com/CLNS. Use the code CLNS to get started today. Couple I like here. More than 1.5 field goals made by Justin Tucker. You know, if he attempts two, he's making them both because he's Mr. Clutch. And then Travis Kelce, listen, 75 yards, couple touchdowns last week against Buffalo. Feels like he and Mahomes have kind of recaptured some of that magic. It's been a little inconsistent this year for Kansas City, but they've turned it on in the playoffs. So like the more on both of those, 10 to win 30 on this entry. Go check out Prize Picks today, prizepicks.com/CLNS. Use the code CLNS. Rapper Meek Mill, comedian Andrew Schultz, other celebrities, they're playing Prize Picks. You should too. Go check them out. Link is in the comments and in the description. The code CLNS gets you a deposit match up to $100. And then let's get to the trade part of this, Coop. Like, listen, I've been on the record saying you can't force a move. Like, it's not just about this year. But if you do want to have any chance this year, what you currently have isn't enough, especially without Kyrie.
Exactly.
And that's kind of the problem, Coop. Like, I'll give Kyrie a lot of credit. He's come in here. He's been a leader, something he has not been at points in his career. He hasn't been an off-the-court distraction. He deserves credit for all that. But the reason I was very hesitant at the time when they traded him is not only does he have off-court distractions a lot of the time, which, again, he hasn't here, full credit. But when you have that plus an extensive injury history, which that has come to fruition here, nothing major, but like minor injuries for him just continue to pile up.
He misses two games here, misses two games there,
I mean, we're going to look up at the end of the year, he's going to have played in like 49 games. Like, he's got to be available, and you don't know if he's going to be, so you got to get more firepower in here.
Yeah, I'm never a fan of making a move just for the sake of making a move, but I kind of feel like they're in the same spot last year where that's what Nico Harrison did with getting Kyrie, and I think that might be what he's going to have to do again here 2 weeks out from the trade deadline. I think this team needs a wake-up call, and I think they need a shake-up, and whether that comes via trade, via the buyout market, or whatever, I think something has to be done in order for this roster to be improved and this rotation to be changed. Because what's happening right now to this team is you can kind of see it falling apart at the seams, and they need to be put back
together. It just happened so fast, too, because like you said it earlier, like last night wasn't all bad. I mean, they came out of the gates humming. I mean, I was very close to texting you, and I'm glad I didn't. I was very close to being like, Daddy Luka taking down Booker and the Suns again, but that just flipped on its head so quickly at the end of the second quarter, and they just didn't recover.
Never.
That's a sign of a bit of a soft team, at least right now. Like earlier in the year, that would not have happened, but for whatever reason, they've just hit the skids here, and they need some kind of shakeup, and it's not just, well, Kyrie needs to be healthy.
Yeah, it's not that simple.
They need something else as well.
It's not that simple, and again, any move the Mavs make is complicated given what their status is with the salary cap and whatnot, so it's going to be difficult for Nico Harrison to make a move that actually impacts this team in a positive way. I just hope that move is coming, and I hope it's coming soon.
Yeah, no doubt about it. So let us know in the comments. Name somebody the Mavericks should trade for. I don't know how you get it done, but I do think someone like a Kyle Kuzma would really help.
I'm going to go same team, but Daniel Gafford. I really think he could help this team, and I think you could get him pretty cheap.
I just think someone in the front court, someone that can score in that regard, because you're so guard-reliant right now, which leads to all these jump shots. Like, I know Kuzma's going to take a lot of jumpers, but he can get that midi game going. He can post up a little bit as well, rise and shoot over defenders. So that is someone I would like to bring in here, but we'll see what they end up doing. All right, Coop, hopefully the Mavericks get this thing back on track.
Yep.
We, of course, will be back tomorrow with another episode of Mavericks Today. Trade deadline 2 weeks away, so we'll see how busy Nico, Cuban, and the boys get between now and then. He's Jeffrey Cooperstein. I'm Harrison Graham. We'll see you next time here on Mavericks Today.